Meat bicycle!
Hello everybody! Welcome back to another episode of the Legendary Run. So, to recap from the last Legendary Run, we got this little beast that's in my hand now, the Blowfly, right at the start of the episode, and then proceeded to come here to Outland Spur and absolutely wreck everything that moved with this thing. Only one thing that let us down, and it was the damn cradle. Hate the cradle, you guys know it, I mention it in every episode, but it's getting really underpowered now. It's not just because it's such a crap weapon, it's getting really, really underpowered. So we need to get ourselves a new shield, and it's total random chance that we're going to get one in a vendor. We could end up with absolute shed loads of legendaries if I do vendor farming. So decided the next phase of our legendary run, although we have got the oxidizer to get from the grinders and the zim to get from a bunch of ice holes, I'm not going to get them yet. We need to get ourselves a new shield, and the only guy that's going to give us that is Bruce, and the only guy that we're going to get it from is not actually available yet, so we need to progress in the story and hopefully get to Pickle's side missions, which aren't available yet. I think the first one's X marks the spot, and then it'll be another Pickle mission. Now I'm going to advance in the storyline a little bit, hopefully kill the bosun, and we're not going to farm him for the cryophobia. We're going to hopefully see if it will activate Pickle's side missions, and then we can go farm that, and then we'll obviously leave the bosun to another day. Badass Kragan's down though, so that's good. Just going to leave his mates. We'll go and pick up this gear because we need money, and yeah, we'll get all these Kragans down because it's good XP, but we need to move pretty quickly now. Go and kill the bosun. I don't think we're going to do it in this episode, so we might have to come out and do the grinders farming. Have we got an O2 kit actually? We've not got a legendary one, it's just a blue one, so yeah, we could do with upgrading our O2 kit as well. But we'll kill these Kragans. In fact, thinking about it, we don't just go straight to the bosun, do we? We actually go miles out of the way. Oh, we've got to stick with the cradle for another day, I think. That's annoying. Very annoying. But it don't matter. It doesn't matter. We'll progress in the mission anyway, and hopefully it will not be long. Within a couple of episodes, we'll get ourselves a new shield. It's going to be pretty hard actually getting through Pity's Fall with our cradle. What level are we now? 14, and the cradle is level 7. You never know, we might hit it lucky. Next episode this episode will be a boss drop legendary. Next episode will be a what will it be? It'll be a vendor drop, so hopefully we might get a vendor a shield, but it's totally random and we could end up without anything, probably, you know, a grenade or something. So it's that's the joy of the legendary run though. The struggles are real, and we'll go on for now and hopefully we'll get lucky. You never know, it's about time we had a bit of luck, I think. Right, let's just be a bit careful in here. And I actually didn't take the time when I started here, so I don't know how long we're going to be going for, but we've been going just under 5 minutes, so don't want to get these episodes too long. Boom, you're down. Okay. We'll just get as far as we can in Pity's Fall for about 10-15 minutes, and then we'll go back and I think we'll farm Rooster Booster, I think it'll be, for the we'll go for Rooster Booster. I can't be bothered to do the Bunch of Ice Holes one because it really is annoying. It's hard to see if it actually drops a legendary. I want a nice easy one, so obviously Rooster Booster is pretty easy, just to run through Stanton's liver and get him. So we'll go for him next, and then obviously we'll go for the supernova, and then we'll come back and get the Zim at a later date. All that before we get the cryophobia. But there'll be plenty of vendor farms in between there as well, so we'll keep upgrading on good gear. I do like the way we do, you know, I've decided to do it where I do a vendor farm in one episode and then a boss farm in the other. It just saves me doing endless boss farming. And legendaries from vendors are pretty good. And obviously once we start to get duplicates and things like that, we can start grinder farming as well. So it's all good. Let's get this badass outlaw down though. I'll keep an eye on my health and I'll call my skill in when I get low. Oh, we are out of ammo again, so time to switch to a striker. This guy is going to destroy me if I don't get him down. I think someone's just spoke to me on Steam as well. I forgot to turn it to offline. I think it's Radu Valens, actually. He's a good guy, actually. He's very helpful, very knowledgeable on the all things Borderlands. Nope, no legendaries. Right, well, shall we actually buy some ammo for once? Pistol ammo, I think we will, because we're going to use a lot of it. We've got plenty of money as well. In fact, let's sell some stuff as well that's not legendary. Going to keep all the whites for the two arms mission, because I always end up selling them and then come to do the two arms mission and I'm like, oh, I've got no whites. Okay. Let's go. Some guys in here. Freeze! Yeah, we're getting really bad on the shield front. We're just constantly running without a shield. Let's call EXE in. What do we get? Funzerker. I like that. Got no one to kill though because he keeps running away. There we go. Right, let's get to these guys as quick as we can. And I'm miles away. It's a good skill this when you've actually got... Oh yeah, let's focus on this badass lunatic. Quick! I don't know where he's gone. There he is. Damn it, not in time. Yeah, it's a good skill, Funzerker, but you've got to be near everyone or it absolutely sucks. Oh, surprise, surprise. The cradle puts me down. Wow, that's the first time that's ever happened. Not... So annoying! Can't wait to get the supernova. That's gonna shut. Right, let's keep. Well, I'm halfway through my ammo already on pistol. Let's kill a few of these guys while we're waiting for this. Hello, boys. We'll go in hip fire mode to save some ammo. Wow, we're nearly level 15 as well, that's good. Do some good levelling up there. But to be fair, it's pretty pointless at the minute because once we get to the bosun and get farming him, we're going to absolutely fly up in levels, hopefully. He's pretty good for that. Oh, God, you got me through a barrier. Where are you? Oh, no. XE, come in. Aha, trap. Quite handy. Because this badass outlaw's going to get absolutely screwed now. Need to get your head, mate. There we go, criticals. Ripped him. Rest in pieces, my friend. Rest in pieces. Right, hurry up, Skipper. Open this door. Thank you. If you want that force field down, you need to go to the engine room. All right, lady. Come on, then. Open the door.
Listen, the bosun's pretty much holding me prisoner and making me do... things for his entertainment, but you're here and you look like the rescuing type.
They're a flipping fool. We'll get this door open, I think, and then we'll go for grinder. Kind of the same thing in my. In fact, I'll open this chest up here and then we'll go for grinder. Because it's quite a long way round, all the way round there. That'll do for another episode. Just come find me. First, I'll come on. Show you how to shut down the bosun's barrier. Oh, come on, woman, just open the door. Yarr. I'll try to help along the way where possible, but I can't let the bosun know we're working together. Okay, so I'll stay quiet. Sorry, just go. Door open now. I'll be in touch. Gonna go get one of his little stashes and then we'll quit out. Get to the engine room. Yeah, it's a long ass mission this. Gotta go all the way around the whole map, so there's no point in doing it now. We can do that in another episode. We've got an oxidizer to get. Okay, I'm at the wrong bit here. No, I'm not. Right, let's... Bit of crowd control.
Sorry about this, but I'm
there we
to
go.
To
now we're right. Open this up. Bosun's mate, part one. Oh, well, we've got a purple. That's better than no. It'll be good for the vendors. Okay, let's go get the grinders mission done then. Time to get our next legendary, guys. Could do with a legendary Oz kit as well, so that's definitely worth doing. We're going to check the vendors as well, just because we quit out. You never know when we're going to get a random orange drop. Nope, nothing there. Right, time to fast travel then. Let's activate it in the mission log. Grinders! So we've got to destroy the scavenger buggy in Triton Flats. Before we do that though, I think I'm going to go for the two chests, because I do want a legendary in the chests out of this run. No, okay. Right, you guys are all going to be stupidly low level, so I'm not going to bother with you lot. Let's boost up here. Oh, how good will it be if we find a legendary in one of these chests? That'll be pretty good, actually. I'm not going to kill any of them. Oh, wow. Even at a low level, they can still destroy this cradle. I'm really going to have to stop moaning about the cradle so much, but I just couldn't believe the luck. No oranges. Well, you're going in the vendor anyway. Any ammo? No. Right, back here. Let's see if I can make it. No, I failed that one miserably. Wow, I didn't even sprint, I don't think. Oh, well, we can go and we don't have to go all the way to the top anyway. We can just do the little barrier trick. Bit annoying because I do like to actually drop on that shack and smash it. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. I should have picked up a car actually while I was there. Save me going back. But I've got to head that way anyway. Right, let's open this chest. There we go. Any oranges in there? If there is, we'll have to run. Oh, that damn turret. There we go. Nope, it's just a green rocket launcher. Yeah, we can pick it up. Good. Nice little tip for you guys there. If you can't be bothered to run there every time, you can just literally open it from the outside. So, off we go. To here. Right, let's go destroy some scavenger buggies. Wow, how weird does that look? A claptrap bin driving a stingray. Oh, got loads of side missions active now, actually. I wonder if... No, I was going to say, I wonder if I can pick up... Well, do you know what? We'll destroy this and we'll just go to Outlands Spur just on the off chance that we can actually... Is that a scavenger buggy? That's a grinder buggy there. We'll go there just on the off chance that we can actually get that shield. It doesn't matter actually. No, we'll go for the oxidizer for now, and then we'll go to Outlands Canyon another time. Obviously, if we're lowish level, the cradle's not going to do us that much harm. But it's just how, well, there's all these side missions active here, and it doesn't tell you in the log. I'm sure in Borderlands 2, when you had undiscovered missions, it actually told you that there was loads of undiscovered missions for you to pick up, but it doesn't seem to in this game. Boom! Okay. Find second grinder. Back to Crisis Scar it is. Stanton's Liver it is then. I don't know if I've actually been in here yet. Is there a storyline mission in here? I'm not sure there is. Oh yeah, I've been in here. We got the... oh no, we didn't. Did we get the Excalibur Bastard? I don't think we did. I think that was in my Doppelganger playthrough. I got it quite early on. Well, we can have a look anyway. We can see it from this cliff, I think. Yeah, we definitely need no 2-kit as well, because I've got no good slam damage. Well, cradle's down already. Excalibastard. Yep, he's still there. Fair enough. That'll do for another legendary run. That'll be an easy one. I think I might save that till maybe near the end of the first playthrough. I'm not too fussed about getting it at level 50 because I've already had it. Ow! Badass little scab. See, level 8 and I've got no shield. Come on, guys. Can I make this jump? Yeah, easy. Easy, easy, easy.
They told me you were a persistent one, even when your wrists are slapped.
Shut up, Rooster.
I have a special surprise waiting for you.
Special surprise? Sounds like a snake of the jungle, but... Oh, look at this with... I was going to say, look at this with parkour skills. Right. Get up here and find the second grinder. He's inside it.
To pieces and get the recombiner matrix out of it. Luckily, they're tough bits of tech too.
Hit the grinder. Boom.
It's tougher than I thought.
Okay, there's Rooster. So, as usual, one time only boss form. So once I kill him, he won't come back unless I make it a read only save file. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now, guys. I'll be back in a minute. Okay, I'm back and we are all read-onlyed up, so we can farm him as many times as we want now. So let's go. Let's go and kill this little git. First time? No. That's I'm going to have to remember to knock him down there, actually, because if not, his loot flies away everywhere. But I don't think he dropped anything then. I didn't see anything. So that's the first one. Luckily, it's not too bad a spawn, really. We'll reselect the character. Go back in and hopefully this has worked and I've got the right file. Yes, I have. Kill Rooster. Nice. I got 6 characters on the go at the minute and I couldn't remember. It's been a while since I did a legendary run. I couldn't remember which character Claptrap was. So luckily I got that right. But yeah, that's the first run anyway. We'll do 3 or 4 runs, I think, of him. And hopefully I'll drop it within them 3 or 4 runs. If not, it's back to filming off camera. Well, that's a long way down. Okay, luckily we can make that jump. And yeah, good for attempt number 2. Hopefully he'll drop it. If not, then I am going to be annoyed. Not really, I'm used to it by now. But it'd be nice to get a drop within 3 at some point. Rooster's already out, so we're going to miss that completely. Ow. Oh, this... Jesus, just let me up here. I've done this 1,000 times. There he is, so we need to knock him down there. There we go, now we can see his loot properly. Get it into a more concentrated area. Nope, nothing there, that's number 2 anyway. Nope, nothing at all, no point in looking around because it's read-only, so we can't pick anything up. Because if we do, then it's just not going to save. Attempt number 3. So, what I want from you guys who are watching is to tell me when you think I... should go and pick up, I'm going to do that, the Excalibastard over there. What level do you think I should stay before I pick it up? Do you think I should wait till level 50, which will be a long, long time away, especially in legendary run terms, because if I do decide to do a true Vault Hunter mode playthrough and then an ultimate Vault Hunter mode playthrough, do I keep it till then or do I pick it up? And that's another thing to think of as well. You know, if people are waiting till level 50 to pick up Excalibastards, what about when Ultimate Vault Hunter mode comes out? Will you be able to get the Excalibastard again or not? Because it's not just a one per playthrough, it's a one per character drop. So obviously, if you pick it up in normal mode, you can't pick it up in True Vault Hunter mode. So do people wait and not pick it up? I think I'm going to leave one character... on my playthrough that hasn't picked it up, so when it does go to Ultimate Vault Hunter mode, I can get a higher level one. I suppose people can just use like save editors and gibbed and things like that, or just dupe them, but to get one legitimately in Ultimate Vault Hunter mode, if and when it comes out, you've literally just got to go for the whole playthrough of True Vault Hunter mode without picking it up. Now luckily for me, I don't like the Excalibastard, I don't use it very much. It's pretty good at the old critical hits, but I don't think it's that powerful and it's slow, so I really can't be bothered with it. But are we on run 3 or 4? I think we're on run 3. No, we're on run 4 actually. Run 4. Okay. Well, we'll do this and one more, and then that'll be it, unfortunately. Oh, no, he's over there. I don't like it. Oh, no. Well, that didn't go very well. Luckily, I think all his loot landed down here. Because if it went down there, we're screwed. Yeah, we'll never get that back. Okay, that's run number 4 then. We'll go for run number 5. And hopefully we can get it this time. If not, farming on my own, unfortunately. But yeah, let me know what you guys think about the Excalibur Bastard, when I should get it. Hopefully, I'm hoping, don't let me influence you here, but I'm hoping you guys say get it at like level 25 or something like that in the first playthrough. Get it out of the way, just so it's on the list. But plus, obviously, if I, you know, if everyone says to leave it to level 50 and I decide I don't want to do a true Vault Hunter mode playthrough for whatever reason, which I'm pretty sure I will do, just because it's fun. And but you never know, some people might get bored of this series and not want to do it. You know, can't see into the future, but I just want to get it out of the way, get it on the list, and I probably won't use it very much. But what level do you guys think I should get it at? Let me know, and I'll see what everyone thinks. Right, you get down there now. Stop being an annoying little git and just die and drop the oxidizer. Nope, and he hasn't. So, that's it anyway, guys. That is another episode of the Legendary Run. Obviously, this is not finished yet. I will be going into the lovely world of off, live, camera, whatever you want to call it, farming. Farming by myself, we'll call it for now. And hopefully, it won't take too long to get the oxidizer. But obviously, as usual, when I finally get it to drop, you guys will see that run, whether it be 6 runs or 60 runs, or in one case 256 runs. Not naming any names, Madame Von Bartlesby. But yeah, anyway, it's here anyway, and I will not be stopping till I get it, so be sure to stick around for that. And in a few seconds time, after I've said goodbye, you will see the run. So I'll see you any minute, or any day in my terms, but for you it'll be any second now. And I'll get the oxidizer. So, for now, I will see you guys in a second. 1 second later. So, here we are anyway, back on another run. Well, actually, another like 70 odd runs or whatever it was. But this is the run where we get the drop anyway. You should all know how this goes by now. So, of course, we are still farming Rooster Booster for the legendary oxidizer. And here we are on the 76th run, actually, which seems quite long, really, but it's not too bad, you know. Well, it is a lot of runs, thinking about it, but there is a drop anyway. But to be honest, after you found Captain Flint 200 times in the last legendary run you did, 75's quite appreciated, really, and it's not really that long a run. But we've gone ahead and picked it up anyway now, and we're just going to go and have a little look at it once I actually make a bit of space. There we go, Arctic Oxidizer. So this is probably one of the best ones, I think, because it's got the cryo damage on it. Max slam damage increased, O2 capacity, all sorts of elemental sort of things. It's a good O2 kit, really, so we're definitely happy about that. And more happy about the fact that we can actually get a legendary Oz kit on now as well, so that's another slot filled with an orange. But as you can see, this is just wrecking, really. I mean, I know I could keep going on about it, but I ain't got the best shield really at all, but it's just one shot in everything, really, and one shot in things with a butt slam. It's pretty entertaining, really. But yeah, that is it anyway, guys. That is part 7 of the legendary run. We have got ourselves an O2 kit added to the list of legendaries now. I'm loving this series, and I hope you guys are too. So next part will obviously be a vendor drop. We'll go ahead and do that. Probably start another episode off with that, because I quite enjoyed that last time with the blowfly. Starting an episode off with a legendary, it just makes the rest of the episode pretty good, really. But yeah, for now, there is once again another legendary in our run, and another one ticked off the list. So for now, thanks for watching, everyone. If you've missed any episodes, there is a link in the description to the playlist for the rest of the legendary run videos. Get them all watched, they are really fun, I think, to play and guess along with and see what you get. And yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. I'll see you guys in the next episode.